Welcome back to Chex Quest 3, which we did once, and now we must do it again, because it's on the Cacowards. It is Cacoward winner number 7. I'm impressed by the fact that Chex Quest 3 exists at all, so we're gonna play it. I don't even know. I think these are actually all chapters, really. Yeah, these are all chapters. Not today. Let's go with Gobs of Goo. I picked up from Slime Repellent. And I got a map. Helps to have a map, they say. Oh, goddammit, really? I think I'm gonna turn on the crosshair for this one. Damn it, they really... For some reason, they changed this stuff. A dot's good enough. Just a slight centralization. If you want to complain, some people actually really do appreciate this stuff. It helps with motion sickness, in some cases. You know, it helps me aim. Should probably resort to melee. Yes! The Mighty Spoon! Where do I go then? Have I missed a button somewhere? Oh, here it is. Freakosaurus Rexus. Yes! Sorching. Wow, this music's good. I wonder if this is custom. So apparently this is made by the guy who actually made the original two games. AKA the canon games, if you're a nitpicker. Ha! The large Sorcher. I want to Sorch with the fury of 1,000 suns. 8 times, to be exact. I love how they put a little copyright notification there. Like, checks copyright armor. Looking to get sorched. I remember this getting really annoying later on. Like, some of the enemies they use are just not good. Or maybe it was me at the time. I was just the baby. Man, I always love those sounds. More grunts. Grunts and groans. Is that a thing I missed? No, it's just a... Impressive how the pistol actually is still useful. Like in most Doom games, the pistol kind of loses its effectiveness very quickly. And that's rarely because there really isn't a reason to keep the pistol around, because every other weapon is better than the pistol. I even think that the minigun is better in just in terms of raw damage, so there's no reason not to use the minigun ever. Shit, this is dark. I got the Rapid Sorcher. Well, ain't that a peach? That's a little winky face! He's a little winky face. This is great. Eat Sorch! Ha, a glass of water. Such good items, though, for like, what it wants to do. I love how the little buttons on the side of these weapons change. The little lights change as you use them. See? Even this one. It's really cool. Oh, god damn it. So for some reason, the people who made this think that weapon toggles should be the other way around. I personally prefer up for forward and down for backwards. Can't see anything. Ha! Ultra goggles. I don't think jumping's allowed, but I think right now I don't really have much of a choice because this is just a pain to see anything in.
There's ooze all over the floor.
Eat Zorch and go back to your slimy planet, I guess. Good music, though. Bam, bam. Real nice. This sound actually came in a full package. Normally, all you get with these things is you get a WAD. You get some data files, and it's like, oh, you gotta use this version of Doom to get it working. But here they come with a legit executable, so you can just start it up and get going. Which is kind of weird, because I'm really used to having to plug in WADs and fiddle around with some options beforehand. And getting to use my own custom control settings and all. Always odd when you get, like, less than 100% items, but you get all the secrets. I wonder if this is Doom or Doom 2. Like, considering the time in which this was released. We need to deploy the heavier weapons. This truly is a rapid Zorcher. I wonder if the double... I really want the double to be in here. Whatever they had to do to get it... It's just such a fun weapon, the barrel shotgun. It's just one of the best weapons in the game. It's the weapon that put Doom on the map. Even though I don't 100% agree with what... I don't like what Doom 2 did in terms of level. Like, the more I look back, the more I'm like, I think Doom 2 kind of went too far with having one giant level pack like that. Like, Doom works a lot better in bite-sized chunks than it does in one giant escapade. Phasing Zorch. Prepare to be phased into another dimension. It's a bit of a heavy gun for right now. Oh yeah, I only pushed a button. What does that button do? Oh, it's unleashed a whole bunch of flumoids. That's what it did. What's the place called again? The United Cereals. Those are Cacowards demons, if I recall correctly. Which justifies the use of extreme firepower. Or in this case, extreme Zorching. Because this is a PG game. Or an E-rated game. We can't have people killing people here. Wow, these guys really love their conference rooms, don't they? Or these might actually be demons, and they're just floating. I actually think they're demons. Pinkies and all. I mean, I've called them pinkies consistently, but that's not their name.
Imagine these flamoids are just, the flamoids are... The little guys are like shotgunners and pistolmen, but they don't feel like them. They have to be, though. They're very weak and flimsy. They function exactly like them. I need ammo, however. What, no surprise door opening? I guess this is Chex Quest, not Doom. Let's not pretend it's something it's not. Well, that's pretty cool. No, and I would have been faster, but who cares? See if I care. I don't care. I only care about this man saying, Zorch! Man, they really don't have trust in you. What does that say? I don't know. A top secret lab leading to a top secret. That's a pretty cool, yeah, that's pretty cool. Good job on that one. I wonder how much of this is carried over. I don't remember everything that's in the original Chex Quest. The exciting video game. Which is amazingly good for a fucking... You have to remember, Chex Quest was a, what's it called? Chex Quest was a game that was included with a cereal box. Like, you got a little... I think it was a... Back in the day, they still did fucking... I don't even know what they're called anymore. Fuck, what they called? Diskettes. They're called diskettes. They still did floppy disks. So you just had a floppy disk in a fucking cereal box, and it had a cool game on it. People are like, we live in a modern age. No, we don't. You don't get fucking video games that are good. You get shitty video games. United Cereals. Chex Metro. Aha. You think you are powerful, but in reality you are weak and flimsy. And I, Chex, am the master of destruction. Uh-oh. Y'all need to calm down and get zorched. Anyone else looking for... Oh, that's cool. I love it when they do that, even though it makes zero sense considering the circumstances we're in. Y'all get searched! Pew pew! Man, this is what I love. Nice shooting gallery. Like, you get little parts where it's a little stiffer. And the ammo is kind of tight in this. But it gives a lot of health. I think I'm going to turn up the difficulty. Which, guess what? Back in the day, you could just fucking do... Shucks. So give me a moment, I'll look up cheats. Apparently that cheat doesn't exist. I don't remember why I remember it. But I'm half considering, I will just see how it works out. If it's a nice easy jog, that's nice compared to last yesterday where I had to cheat my way through things. We get some phasing Zortra. Ah, we're gonna need it. Those are big boys. You guys better learn a lesson. Might. Nope, just making sure that I actually could get hurt. I don't know what this weapon is even called. Like, you get weapon names for everything but the pistol. The pistol's always up to community interpretation. Bam! Bam! Okay, so we're gonna scout the area a bit, get some information. Love it. Uh-oh. Okay, big boy. Okay, so we're gonna have to go here. Unless we go over here. I'm gonna need you some heavier guns. Ah, I got a lot of phasing, Zorch. Do I have any, I have only one propulsion. Propulsion, so we're gonna have to do with the phasing for a bit. I guess it's just ambient Zorch noises. Now, the thing is, I'm not too accurate with the with this as I am with most weapons. Like, I'm very good at estimating weapon shots for enemies, because I've played so much with the weapons, but I never use the plasma gun in an accurate fashion. I just stockpile them, and then I just go for it. Boy got zorched. That's a Caco Demon, has to be. You wanna get zorched? Eat some propulsion! I wonder who the reverends are. I don't think we've seen any of them. These guys are putting up a stiff resistance. We're dealing with some masters of Fleminoid scum. That was a lot of ammo wasted on thin air. Good, great sound effects though. A little. They're very stock, but they did get the job done. Yeah, it's gonna do, boy. I know what I'm gonna do. Clearly, this is the place to use this one. Yeah, I think there are no reverends and all. Then I will spoon you to death! Or not. Whatever, I had the health. Because I remembered this being much tougher than the other Chex quests, so I was like, I'm going to play this on normal, because the Chex quest games are easy, but this one was hard, if I remember correctly, and I didn't. Aha. Uh-huh. I opened an ancient Chinese skirt. Of course, Chex Villa would grow nothing but the finest of apple trees and the most delicious of waters. Now there's a key in here somewhere. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Like I said, great music. Like, considering these are MIDIs, they picked some great instruments for the music to jam out to. Huh. I think I'm there, yes. Got the yellow key. This is some great work, by the way. Getting this to work out proper. Ah, the Mona Chexa. Beautiful work of art, if you ask me. The Laz device! Large area zorching! I'm prepped for combat. Who are these people? One's a donut, the other's a man. Who of you wants to get sorched first? This best. Oh no, I don't have any. I'm gonna have to rely on my old wits. Really isn't a situation that requires any sort of large area of zorching, so I'm gonna take it easy. A door has opened. Red keycard behind it. Of course! most powerful of weapons invented by humanity and Chexmanity.
You freaky Fleminoids. You'll never win.
Ah, propulsion packs.
But those are even mightier than before.
Some really good design, too. It's really dark, though. Ah! A slime-proof suit will allow me to traverse these dangerous pathways completely safe. This requires some large area searching. Ah, that portal is a tight squeeze, as they call it.
Villa check's finished.
Sweet Lazarus on a stick! Large area zorching was the only way to solve that one.
Frick. Running low on Zorch. I think I'm gonna have to employ this pupper.
Yeah! I booted him straight out of here with some grade A Zorch action.
Supercharged breakfast for a supercharged hero.
Of course, Chex doesn't mind getting soggy. Chex tastes great, even in milk. Got 3 sword charges left on my Mega Sorcher. I think it's called Large? Large Sorcher. Ah, some ammo. That my large sorcerer is ready for action.
Oh, that's a drill. Yeah, sorry about the drill. But there's some construction work going on next to this house, so I can't help it, but it's gonna happen.
You're gonna have to shoulder the blame, as they call it. Oh, slime repellent. And some Chex armor.
I wonder where that slimy snot-nose is hanging out, thinking he can escape his just dues. Oh, he'll be unpleasantly surprised.
A Chex warrior does not surrender!
I have a lot of ammo for some things, yeah. Although Spoon generally cleans up those guys nicely, too.
I'll be Little Spoon, you be the Dead Spoon!
Torched.
big boy back there.
Spoon power! Or should I say spork power? For the true power is not found in the fork or the spoon, but a healthy combination of both.
The yellow key. Just what I needed.
You thought you could trick me and ambush me at my weakest moment, when I was opening a door. But you were wrong. And I was right. You see, another reason I like the double barrel is it makes those guys a lot less annoying. It really loves giving you armor. Zorched.
You better go back to your own world, you fiendishly slimy boogers.
Ha!
He thought he could hide from me, but he couldn't.
A lot of water out here. A Zorch pack. Now my Zorch carrying capacities have improved!
Aha! Another cigarette.
That's a supercharged breakfast. Mostly mine carts. Someone was digging. Probably an illegal, flemenoid excavation operation, who knows.
That's cute. Like, it really likes giving you health, just not ammo.
That sport shortback was a great relief. What did I pick up then? Oh, I probably opened this door. A door which contained only a key, for some reason. Figure out a perfect plan for this guy. I guess that's why it gives you so much health, so you can melee more. Yeah, this is the part I hate it. Those, in case you're wondering, are... Those are the lost souls. And they suck. They're not that fun. Because there's just so many of them, and they come out of nowhere. Which is why you rarely use lost souls in, like, open environments without a heads-up warning. Just look at this. Look at this. I should have a rocket, right? Look at this! This is why I remember this being so annoying. Like, this isn't Doom 2, so there's no pain elemental story about. There's just a lot of these guys. What are they, though, like in the canon? Yes, in the exciting Chex canon. There's a whole backside, of course. The Earth is becoming encrusted with mysterious, slimy, flaminoid energy. Even that doesn't kill him fast enough. Meteor spaceship. So this is how the Fleminoids got on our planet. Then this is how I'll send them back. Why do they even have Zorch ammo laying around? The sound's still the same. Vegetables are really good for you. I love how this game is so stuck in its time. Would like, please eat healthy. Someone wants me to use a facing torture. I know the saying, ask and you shall receive. Just remember to ask nicely. Aha! Another Zorch repeller to buffer in my arsenal. Ah, that's cute. They took the skull key and made it something cuter. Something they could market. The power of the spork compels you. Or does it? That ought to clean him up. That's all it gives me is glass. Yeah, this feels a lot more like classic Doom design, which is the weird part about it, is it starts off giving you all this health and equipment you don't need it. And then it suddenly does this. And it follows the same design, it follows a different design philosophy all of a sudden. We're going nuclear. Sometimes you have no choice. To employ the nuclear option. On the plus side, I get him a lot of Zorch packs. Yeah. Some vegetables too. Frick yeah. These Fleminoids got some great traps set up. That's pretty nasty, though. Impressive tech, that much is true. Get Zorched, slime balls. Holy shit, what is that? What is that? He's a big guy, that much is certain. But advanced sorching technology always wins. Frick. Advanced Sorch Equipment. Magnificent. Why am I sending their weapons back like that? That's not a very smart plan, is it? Oh well. Trap's gonna spring shut right on top of me. Apparently not. That having been said, I would understand if they thought that they could stop me earlier in my tracks, and their defenses were focused on earlier environments. Neither of these doors open. Ah, some powerful Chex armor. The weapon of a true soldier. A whole bunch of these beans, too. Ah. What the fritzel fraggle, man. Finally, they give me something to work with. My armor's in good shape. I'm health up. Oh, that thing looks nasty. It's time to large area Zorchum. The closer you get, the more effect this magnificent weapon has. And Zorched. Wait, there was something about this that kind of tipped me off. Magnificent. Five large area Zorches. That's what it took. Well, that was fun. Derek City is really good. But it has some really big problems with the difficulty towards the end. No roll call. Oh, wait, we get this. I know what this is. This is so cute. It's so cute! Donut, Bagelman, and Chexman. That's great. I love it. Chex Quest is like such a weird thing to come along. You get a really good Doomwad. The first two were kind of eh. But, you know. Don't ever linger on a note when you're using a MIDI file, by the way. That never works. It never does. It just sounds awful. But I'll see you guys next time. Next time, we're taking a sneaked peek at Escape from Castle Chezcria. Which sounds exciting and also thematically fitting since we just played Chex. Although it's called Chez, with C-H-E-S, Kriya. Which is really cool. Escape from the Castle Chez is a tech base. A gothic tech base. Sounds cool. And after that, it's cold as hell. That's it. Actually, doesn't that make... Ah, shit. The other one is 7, isn't it? Ah, darn it.